Hello, my name is Kristen Nugent, and I will be presenting the research project evaluation of five concern for falling measures in people with lower extremity amputations. People with lower extremity amputations have a particularly high risk of falling. More than 50% of these individuals will fall each year. There are many factors that influence a concern for falling, both psychological and physical. In order to better understand the many components of concern for falling, we developed a concern for falling conceptual model. The model includes five separate components of falling. It includes fear of falling, falls efficacy, mobility efficacy, consequences of falling, and perceptions of falling. Additionally, to evaluate the many components of these subdomains, we have identified previously developed standardized scales. This includes a modified survey of activities and fear of falling in the elderly to evaluate fear of falling, activity-specific balanced confidence scale, and the Falls Efficacy Scale International to evaluate falls efficacy, the Locomotor Capabilities Index and Amputee Scale, and the Prosthetic Limb Users Survey of Mobility to evaluate mobility efficacy, Consequences of Falling Scale to evaluate consequences of falling, and to evaluate the perceptions domain, we identified Perceived Ability to Manage Falls Scale and Perceived Control over Falling. All of these subdomains of concern for falling have substantial influences on overall quality of life. However, among these measurement tools, only the mobility efficacy assessments were developed for individuals with lower extremity amputations. And the activity-specific balanced confidence scale is the only additional tool to show reliability and validity within a lower limb amputee sample. The others were developed for community-dwelling older adults, and therefore they may not capture the unique mobility and concern for falling experiences of people with lower extremity amputations. Additionally, these scales have only been administered in person. Therefore, demonstrating the mode of delivery virtually is essential in this changing research environment. The objective is to evaluate test-retest relative reliability in the five concern for falling measures. This was done through two online surveys given to people attending a prosthetic rehabilitation program at Parkwood Institute. Individuals were eligible to participate in the study if they had a major lower extremity amputation and completed a prosthetic rehabilitation program. An a priori sample size of 20 individuals was calculated. We evaluated relative reliability of these scales through inter-class correlation coefficient values, and the clinical utility value was set at 0.70. Further, ICC values were categorized into three categories. 0.70 to 0.79 is considered fair, 0.80 to 0.89 is considered good, and equal or greater than 0.90 is considered excellent. Our study sample included 22 participants, the majority of which had transtibial unilateral level amputations. And as expected, dysvascular diseases were the primary cause of the majority of amputations. After calculating the intra-class correlation coefficient values for all scales, the modified survey of activities of fear of falling in the elderly scale had the largest ICC value of 0.92, indicating excellent relative reliability. The falls efficacy scale had a good relative reliability value of 0.87, and the consequences of falling and perceived ability to manage falls scale had a fair reliability of 0.78 and 0.73, respectively. The perceived control over falling scale had a lack in variability in the total score values, and the ICC value could not be validly calculated and was not further analyzed. Although we now have evidence to support the test-retest relative reliability of these four concern for falling clinical scales and administration of these scales in an online format, we still have concerns regarding the validity of the scales for this specific population. We have heard anecdotally from individuals with limb loss and physicians that some of the questions on these scales are inappropriate to the functional abilities of these individuals. We will be assessing validity of these scales in our second project. Thank you.